Namaste, love and light, everyone. I hope all is well with you guys. I woke up feeling good, so good today. So good today. I hope you guys woke up feeling amazing. Okay, so I hope y'all can hear me. Let me put this right here. Okay, so let's see what is coming out, okay? Because envy, you know, y'all, it was at the top of the deck for a minute. So y'all could have been dealing with someone that was very jealous of you, okay? I feel like you guys are coming out of that cycle here. You guys done a lot of healing, and I feel like those karmics could be tied up here, okay? I feel like something could have happened overnight, okay? And, you know, yeah, somebody magic I'm getting did not work, but I'm getting more than that. It backfired. Somebody magic backfired. Okay, it could have been last night. Wow. A lot of, wow. So, but this horn, this throat chakra, you could have sent some type of prayer out into existence to protect yourself from somebody wicked and evil, and that magic backfired here. I feel like your ancestors could have even did a back to sender and protected you. But this horn is giving me judgment, okay? Somebody received judgment. Harsh judgment here. Yeah, your spirit guides, your ancestors pulled through and trampled someone. All right, Archangel Michael, he's looking down at this person. This person is defeated. This karmic is defeated, okay? Their magic is going to totally backfire in 360 on them. And they may have even had a vision of something crashing here. They're having, nightmares. That's their future. That's their magic backfiring. That's the archangels letting them know. Archangel Metatron letting this person know, hey, I'm in control. You're not in control, karmic. Okay? Karmic energy backfired here. They're in the ground, spirit is saying. They're in the ground. They're in the dirt. The archangels effed them up here. You're protected. Now they're stuck. They're undecided. Okay? The archangels chose your side. I'm here. All right? Not to be ego-based or anything, but in the sense of they protected you. All right? This person's name is in the ground, not yours, because you're an angel of love. You're a goddess. You're here to spread love. Your voice is love here. You give out a lot of power, a lot of love, a lot of energy. All right? And you're coming out of some type of poverty-based energy I'm getting. You may have been going through some things financially, or these people are trying to steal from you, take from you. You're getting all that back. Anything that they stole from you, I'm hearing your royals. Okay, so you know we're all royal bloodline, right? If they were trying to steal anything connected with you spiritually, all right, that's also connected with your spiritual royalties, you're getting that back. Like we did discuss your crown, they could steal that, your chalice. Well, try to steal it, okay? Or just stagnate it, or just stop you from, you know, harnessing that energy. But you're coming out of that. It's like your destiny. You're walking along your destiny. It's protected. You're going to have your riches, your success, your abundance, everything. Your crown, like I said, your intuition, your spiritual gifts. You're getting all that back. This person was trying to steal that from you. All right? Spirit saying they were stealing it. So they was harvesting your energy. This person was doing a lot of energy harvesting, and they was harvesting energy from a lot of people. Oh, my goodness gracious. Okay? Because they was trying to steal your journey or walk the same path or journey as you, or they was even trying to, follow you. I'm getting, I'm hearing carry as well. Carry you. So with that carry you though, I'm getting I don't understand that. It's something about you, okay? And it makes them want to follow you and just carry you around. They could have been a bit obsessed, but I'm also getting energy harvesting. That carrying you is for someone. Maybe you guys want to get married. Along your journey, you're going to get married, okay? That's a part of your temple path, your journey. All right, maybe that's what spirit is saying, and this person may know that. That's why they were sending you a lot of conflict, because they know what your future holds. I'm hearing behold, okay? And right when I said that, envy came out, so it's behold. The case of the witches, the moment that you manifest your golden age right here, you get attacked here, you come across a bunch of jealous, evil people comparing themselves to you, thinking that you're stealing their energy, trying to copy their gifts. I'm getting, you know, steal their techniques when you're just your true authentic self. It's like you see through all this. Archangel Michael, Metatron, Uriel, they see all this. Gabriel, they see everything. And they see where these people's intentions start from. It's with envy. Okay? You see these envious people tapping into your energy, I'm hearing. It's like they try to block your third eye. These people try to block your third eye here, and you see everything. Yeah, you're healed. You healed overnight. And somebody magic backfired overnight. It's like they felt that hex on top of them because they know you're a healer. They know you're blessed. I'm seeing a star. You know, they know that you're loved. You're destined here, all right, to be great. And part of your destiny is infinite protection. That's that infinite love. Yes, infinite protection. Like, that's what I'm getting. Your ancestors are always going to guide you. You're shielded and protected, okay, by a bunch of hearts. Them hearts are love. Understand, love surpass fear, for sure. It's way more powerful than fear. These people are at the bottom here. Not, no offense. All right, and it's not to be funny, but in the sense of their attitude, their energy, their vibration, it's very low. You are in a higher vibration. That's why, you know, a lot of you guys could have woke up feeling good this morning, too, or you just woke up feeling more enthusiastic. That's that full moon, that new moon in Aries. It works for you, all right? These people are stuck because they should have focused on themselves instead of focusing on you, all right? It's like these people are going to be watching you, seeing how their magic backfire, and seeing how you are going to be very successful and prosperous with this man holding a coin. I'm seeing you guys having your own business, all right? Owning your own products here and making a lot of money from it. All right, whatever it is that you plan to do, this could even be somebody coming in wanting to help you. If somebody was doing black magic on your person, your husband, your spouse, it's not working here. All right? Yeah, I feel like you are going to have or find this caring connection. Or you have that with someone now. Someone is new coming in, and I feel like a bunch of Jezebels here was trying to stress you out with black magic to keep you away from your person. It's like they was in competition with you, trying to keep you away from your person here. Whoever Jezebel spirits that's attached to him, rather he's with them or not, they was jealous. I'm getting, this is someone that was, these people, they were jealous of the fact that your person found a new beginning with you, and all his exes that was attached to him was attacking you, trying to stress you to freak out, okay? I feel like you and your person probably had to take a break for a while, okay, to clear that energy out. These people could have been the ones that were still attacking you now, okay? But look, you're focusing on your blossoming abundance here. That love frequency is attracting that abundance. You guys know I made a post talking about self-care and gratitude. The angel of love is definitely giving me self-care energy, okay, because you loving yourself attract abundance. Let me go to the post. Right here is on my Instagram. The importance of self-love and gratitude. Self-love allows you to love others. Self-love attracts your healing ability, activates your healing abilities. Loving yourself helps you connect with God and your angels. Showing gratitude to self helps you become more happy. Okay, being gratitude helps you connect with the 5D, love frequency. Gratitude shifts your perspective. Gratitude attracts luck. Okay, so yes, being in love and light and gratitude, all right, and taking care of yourself, always attract abundance. I was about to say and also, so I meant to say something else as well. It's like that self-love, okay, and the love that you put out is also attracting that abundance. You guys may worry like, damn, all the love I put out there to people, is it going to pay off? And it will. The lesson that you learn, you always receive rewards, okay, always. You're on the right journey here. I just feel like you guys, you know, stumbled across some deceitful people. You know, people that was, you know, could have been fully ego-based here. And you, but this world is like you had to separate. I'm getting separate with this world. I don't know why. Because he's by himself. He's like isolated. Some of you guys, you just had to isolate yourself from the world. All right? And I feel like you doing that could have brought your person into your life. I know, but there's some... You have attachments here, but there was so many attachments here that was coming in between you and your spouse, your person, all right? The person that you were supposed to meet, because some of you guys, you've been supposed to meet this person if y'all haven't met them, but there was just so much spell work going around, okay, or people just trying to change your life. It's like it stagnated that. But things are changing for you. A lot of success is coming in. I feel like somebody try to take that success away from you, the success that you manifested for yourself, the success that you're destined to have, I feel like somebody try to take that away. Okay, that's why the financial constraints is in reverse. It's like you're getting all your rewards back. Everything that this person tried to take from you spiritually, you're getting that back. Your spiritual gifts and everything. Okay? And your gifts are going to enhance, and you may even increase. They may even increase because you defeated this karmic. I mean, you defeated this battle. So, of course, there's great rewards and soul growth, okay? Walking away in heart chakra. Yeah, a lot of you guys had to walk away and isolate yourself from people and just not talk to anyone anymore and focus on your ancestors, your inner self, and you know, your growth, I'm hearing as well, in order for you to find love with this heart chakra. But I feel like it's like you focusing on yourself is what attracted love. You attracted that same person because maybe back then you wasn't really on that level of focusing on self. Maybe you were so busy caught up with those deceitful people, okay, that was stealing from you, all right? But it's like now that you're focusing back on you, you elevated and ascended, and you came across someone or will come across someone that is on that same level. So it's like when y'all come together, it's like there's going to be mutual understanding. It's going to be mutual right away. That's what I'm getting, like energetically. Y'all going to be on the same page. I feel like your money is healing as well. The heart chakra is healing energy. Your money is healing. Your finances is healing. Okay? And yes, you see how she's walking towards this card, the seventh chakra, the crown chakra? I feel like you're stepping into a whole new universe. A whole new dimension here. You unlock some... you unlocked a dimension. Like, you have access to a dimension now. Okay? You have access to it, and you're going to gain a lot of wisdom from this dimension. There's a lot of beings waiting for you there in that dimension, okay, to teach you, okay, to teach you things so you can spread this knowledge and light with others. All right, Spirit is saying spread your wings and fly, okay? It's like you left this dimension here, this 3D paradigm, and you have ascended. And this is beyond the 5D. I feel like you already have access to the 5D at any time. You have access to a new dimension. Maybe it is the 7th, but I feel like it's higher than that. Okay? It's somewhere only wise beings can come, can go. That's what I'm getting. Not much people could have not much people have access to this dimension. Or not much people, you know, go to this dimension, period. But there's a lot of wisdom there, okay? To teach you some things. Those are things that I was downloading. Y'all, excuse the background noise. I feel like y'all may discover this in the astral realm when y'all go into meditation. I feel like you guys are really deep spiritually. Like, you guys, you know, astral travel a lot. Y'all do a lot of things spiritually, okay? Because doesn't this, like I said, the world don't look like it's spiritual? First it was isolation, now it's like you isolated in the spiritual realm. So I feel like you guys had to separate from everyone, even on a spiritual level, to find yourself. And I feel like you did that through meditation, astral travel. Okay, you could have even saw your soulmate while you was astral traveling or in meditation. You saw a vision of someone that could potentially be your soulmate here. Or you saw a bunch of this, or you saw in your meditation of this whoever it was that was affecting your love life, that could have separated you from someone that was putting hexes and curses on your love life. I feel like you could have discovered that, whoever it was. Okay? We have Angel of Strands here. I feel like you could have saw a vision strongly. Okay? That's not for everyone. Hold on, I want to get the other deck. Spirit is blocking something, though, with the Seven of Wands here. Blocking some type of karma that somebody is sending out towards you. I feel like somebody is... I picked this up yesterday. I just didn't upload the video. I will. I just have to cut some things. This King of Swords, he always gives me Archangel Michael or God, depending on energy. I'm getting Archangel Michael right now. There could be a fire sign. Don't have to be. Or somebody that's just really angry at you. Okay, that could be powerful and magical. he or she is sending Archangel Michael after you to send you some type of judgment. And I feel like it's being rejected. This person, that could be part of the backfiring energy, is that this person is feeling that shit backfiring on them. It's like something about their back. It's like the shit is attached to them. It's like, if anything, they think that they sent Archangel Michael to kill you or to harm you, but really he saved you from whatever negative energy that they was trying to send your way. Okay, that's what's being blocked. Yeah, I can't make it up. I'm hearing separation spell, so somebody could even try to send you a separation spell, and I'm hearing a death spell, and that was sent back here. All right, you are separate. That's probably the people who you separated from, and it could even be your partner. The moment you separated, you went separate ways. Y'all parted ways. These people started to attack you here. All right, talking about you behind your back. All that was blocked here because you're meant to be prosperous. I feel like these people, whoever, you know, these envious people, or even your person, I feel like they were stealing from you. With this King of Pentacles reverse, I feel like they were stealing your energy, harvesting your energy that is meant to come to you to make you successful on your platform, in your business, your work, your job, your career, whatever it is that you're building. My phone just dinged, so that's confirmation. You guys are protected by feathers. I feel like this, whoever these entities are, these people are, they was attacking your angelic team. It was like war, okay? But they were stealing from you. That's why they're going to receive karma, all right? They unrested, and they're very stagnant here because the past has caught up to them, okay? These people also, they were trying to confuse your intuition so you won't know what's going on with them, what they're doing to you behind your back, all right? So, yeah. Yeah, look, you left it behind. These people that was catfishing, who was not who they appeared to be, you left it behind. Leaving the past behind. You left the past behind, and this person got the past following them. All right, that's what I'm seeing. Like, the past is going to catch up to these people very soon, if not right now. Last night, somebody did receive some karma, though. Something did backfire last night. But I'm also seeing, like, throughout these next few years, months, years, a lot of shit is going to be catching up to them. Like, they can't run from it. Ooh, and my cards, oh my God. And I feel like that truth, somebody hearing that truth, it's gonna be bizarre for them. They're not going to be expecting to hear that. They don't want to hear karma being served to them. Because we just saw they try to send you karma using the archangels. Okay? The angelic realms. Halloween. Could be some witches here. I feel like witches was definitely playing with your love life. Doing love spells and stuff on your love life. Alright? Trying to make you quit your job. Somebody could have been doing spell work to make you quit your job here. Alright? That's what I'm getting. For you to find a new job. They could have been doing spell work for you to find a new job. All right, you went through many phases, which led to your karmic rewards. That's what I call it, karmic rewards. When you go through karmic warfare and you reap the rewards for coming out of it, you know, not just alive, but you learning your lessons and you dealing with it the righteous way, okay? And you learning your lessons is what leads you to your blossom in abundance, because you know better now. You walked away from it, remember? And you chose to focus on your spirituality. Okay? That's what you chose to do. Okay? All of this is ending now. All the phases you went through, they didn't last long. People put hexes on you so these phases can last forever, and they never last. They wanted you to be an addict. People could have been going around saying that you're an addict, or you look like an addict here, or they try to say that you have addictions, like you're addicted to something, all right? Addicted to your thoughts. I don't know. Maybe somebody's thoughts is addicting here. I don't know why I'm getting that. Then I'm getting a song replaying. So some of you guys may have a song replaying over and over in your mind. Somebody could be constantly thinking about you, and they're sending you songs and messages. All right, mirroring. Wow, I can't make it up. Experiencing similar energies. Y'all been going through it. Y'all been going at it, spirit is saying, with the same energies for a long time. And all that shit is backfiring. Because they're messing with you. And it's like, they can't believe it. They can't believe they did what they did to you, but they did it. It's like, if they can go back in time and change it, they would, but they can't. Look, something about tarot reading. Somebody has gotten a tarot reading done. All right, somebody is talking to demons through their tarot cards. That energy is being reflected back, so in a sense of that's going to be exposed. that somebody
talks to you. Hi, guys.
Mommy. Can you pour me some water?
Hi. Okay, Bobby.
Go ahead, go before you stop the video. Okay, so if somebody did any readings on you, that's coming back around here. All right, whatever I'm getting, whatever tarot reading they done, okay, or whatever tarot reading they paid someone, it's coming back around. Like, somebody's either getting exposed for doing readings, or whatever their reading said is coming to pass, okay? Like, the reading could have said that they was going to fail, they was going to lose, and now it's coming to pass, or the reading could have exposed that, the reading or the reader could expose that they was going to get in trouble for all this, everything was going to come to pass, and they probably didn't believe it, but now it's manifesting, and now they add a fork in the road, and they need to make a decision. Everything that they try to put you through is on them. It's karma. Yeah, the grass was fake. Whatever energy that made them feel or thought that what they was doing was righteous was fake. The grass was not greener. I'm sorry, the grass was greener because it was fake. Yeah, somebody could just be simply fake and you dealt with a lot of fake people. Could be over like 7 fake people you dealt with throughout your life. I mean, well, throughout these past few months, okay? And they all receive karma. They all try to change your life, change your outcome, and they all receive karma. Mommy, there's no water in there. Yeah, because you're protected by angels. Your path is protected by angels. There's no water, please. Please.
April Fool's.
It's April 2nd. Can you pour me some water? Listen, you guys, I feel like you guys need to leave a glass of water out for your guardian angels, okay? All right, your ancestors, and your angels said, relax, clear your mind, don't worry about this, we got you. They was trying to blackmail you, and now they're getting blackmailed. Somebody is getting blackmailed here, because everything that they said is coming back around on them, and some type of tarot reading is being mirrored back, like something is true. Something is coming out to be true here. Sexual fantasies. Someone is having sexual fantasies about you. That's being exposed. I don't want that. I want water.
Why are you
being difficult, Amani?
Why you want water, Bobby?
I don't want that. I want water. Can you please give me some water? I feel like that's being exposed, that somebody was like either masturbating, with your energy, basically using your energy in a sexual way, or some type of sex magic is backfiring. Some type of sex magic could be backfiring here. Yeah, somebody's skeletons. Secrets are about to be revealed here. Some type of tarot reading came out to be true, and they skeletons is about to come out here. That's what's being mirrored back, is that they karma is gonna, a part of their karma is things being exposed. Their skeletons either being exposed or, sorry y'all, I should have been turned that tablet down. They're, I don't know.
Water. And that's
cherry
cup.
Give it to me.
This is cherry cup.
Alright.
Just take it. There's
already water. I don't know how this situation is going to play out for these people. Okay, I really can't tell you how it's going to play out for them, but some type of tarot reading. I want to clarify it, but some type of tarot reading, all right, was done. That could have exposed someone. See, that judgment, that's that karma. Someone's karma here is being served, like I said. Somebody got a tarot reading done from, like, a professional or something like that. And that, yeah, I feel like that's true. And that person said they're going to receive a lot of karma. Because whatever skeleton they got in their closet is going to be exposed. And that's for messing with you. Alright? And that energy is being revealed now. Revealed now here. It's like it backfired. Somebody, with this addictions and cuffing season, like I said, this person put hella like hexes and curses on your love life. Somebody may get exposed for being addicted to attacking people, lovers, or is addicted or obsessed with a certain lover here, and they need to like purify the energy from somebody that's stubborn. I feel like somebody is very stubborn and they having a hard time clearing their energy from you. Okay. Or, yeah, and they're sending you evil eye. Oh my God, they're evil eye on your life purpose. And it's like your life purpose gave someone some type of breaking point. Okay? And it made them, like, copy you. Steal your energy. Harvest your energy. A lot of people did. They thought stealing your energy would give them some type of upgrade. Like, they would have your blessings. And that was denied. Spirit blocked that communication. Somebody is strongly trying to say, this is what you did. And they're lying. As I said that, look. This is... You see, blocked communication was here. Lying is next to it. Right when I said that. The reason why it was blocked, because this person is lying. You're not attacking this person. Somebody is maybe even getting exposed for being a bit crazy. They overthink a lot. All right, look, astral travel. Some of you guys may astral travel and you guys may have saw this person lying. All right? They're going to be apologizing to you, even if it's within themselves. They're saying sorry to themselves. All right? Forgiving themselves. They're going to do that soon. But, yeah, because they know that they was inspired by you. You are inspirational to someone. All right? Your body and everything. I don't... Yo, this is some weird energy. I want to clarify tarot reading. Let me just see what this oracle card has to say about tarot reading. It's something fishy about that. Toxic family. Oh my gosh, it was fake. The grass was fake here when it come down to a toxic family. Alright, so maybe some of you guys trusted someone and you guys realized that this person is fake. They're toxic. Somebody could have tried to say that your family is toxic, and now they're saying it's realizing that that was fake. Like they was lying on you and your family, or their intuition lied. Okay, but somebody got a tarot reading done and said that your family was toxic. And they could have exposed all your damn skeletons. Well, that energy is being mirrored back about this person. And now they're starting to see their real skeletons. Because they're receiving headaches. You see? When this person did some type of spiritual attack on you, all these people, if it was like a gangbang thing, it backfired, like we said. And it's causing them some type of headache. All right? I'm hearing betrayal. So for some of you guys, these people, they betrayed you. It was like they conspired and they knew that they were going to betray you. So that's why it backfired so soon like that, so instant. But now these people are receiving headaches and they're realizing like, damn, like this person is really crazy. They're really toxic. They're really after, you know, divine feminine or masculine. You're not doing anything. Okay? Like you're a balance here. And this person, they need to work on themselves. They need to work on more balance within themselves. Yeah, somebody needs to balance out their money. Your money is being balanced out. All that negative energy is being kicked out here. That's what I'm getting. All those hexes, the clothes are the hexes. They're being kicked out by spirit. You're not going to be stagnant. You have a new view, a new perspective. I just can't believe it. So a lot of people are in shock. I even can't believe it, and I don't even know what's going on. I'm just reading what the cards are saying, but I'm shocked like you guys. Some type of toxic family situation is, like, shocking. Okay, like, maybe something was revealed within the family which makes it toxic here. Okay? But somebody comes from a toxic-ass family, and it was revealed through a tarot reading. Look, and people are seeing through the fog, or you already been saw it. Alright, but your vision is getting clear, so if they were trying to block your crown or your third eye, that's being healed. Alright, people are starting to see that this person is toxic, or they come from a toxic-ass family. Or they have a toxic family member that may argue with them, that could be abusive as hell. Okay, this kid could be stressed out. Okay, they could have had a toxic-ass relationship. Alright, with their exes. Yeah, look, stuck in the past. Toxic-ass relationship with their exes, that's being revealed. Somebody needs help here, look. And they be doing spell work on people. Yup, spell work. They be manifesting against people to keep them stuck and stagnant with this submerged emotions. It's like you feel, it's like you in a sunken place, okay? But you can't get out of it, all right? Oh, my God. Somebody past is coming back around here. You're protected. Ooh, divinely protected. Oh, my God. Times 10, 3, all the numbers. Infinite. All right, infinite, like we said, infinite protection. That's why I ain't getting no numbers. You're infinite protected from all spell work. Someone has been casting spells. I told you, hella love spells, hella exes and shit. It was a phase. Y'all are coming out of that phase of spell work. People constantly trying to backstab you, betray you, take you down with spell work. Now everything is backfiring on them, and now they feel betrayed because their spell work is causing them. Headaches. I'm seeing like a knife stabbing their head, their crown. They have a sharp headache. All right, look. Oh my God, spirit, thank you.
sharp headache. That's how they feel. Things are becoming too much to bear. They feel like that shit backfiring like that. Oh my God. Like, whatever they try to manifest against you, all right, is manifesting against them. Okay? Well, whatever they try to manifest towards you, like whatever nonsense, is actually manifesting for them. All right? They're childish. And they try to say you copycat them, but really they're copycatting you. They're very childish here. Okay? You know exactly who it is. That's what I'm picking up again. You could have saw like a hair, like signs of like their hair. Okay, in the sense of their hair texture. If they have like curly hair, you probably saw that in a vision. Spirit told you to cleanse your space of these people, of this family. I told y'all in my community post that there's a toxic ass family here that could have even been getting tarot readings done on you, but they was doing spell work. Everybody's gonna see that these people are evil. Okay, you need to cleanse your space. Break those hexes or curses here that these people were sending on you by just burning some sage. You guys are highly ranked spiritually. You guys are divine. You're royal. Okay? You have divine souls. All you have to do is call on your spiritual team. Call on Archangel Michael. Alright? And you, those curses will be broken within 24 hours. One day. These people try to cut your tongue spiritually so you can't call out for help. That's being healed. And their tongue is being cut. It's being sliced. So they can never see through the fog. They can never see things clearly. Okay? And it's like they can't call out for help. While they're stuck, clouded, they can't call out for help. That's what they try to do to you. All right? Look, you're finding balance here. Cleansing yourself, burning you some sage is going to find you some balance here. Even if you do it, listen, sometimes when I'm like in meditation and I'm dealing with people like negative thoughts, you guys, I meditate laying down. All right, I don't crisscross applesauce. I do play high frequency music sometimes, but I'm like a master of my mind here. All right, and my ancestors, you know, they helped me, they trained me with all the stuff that I went through. And you guys are masters of your mind too. So you know, when you know, I'm just laying in the bed meditating on the energy that is trying to follow me, I would just envision myself burning a sage stick, and I'm just saging that energy away. Some of you guys can do that to balance out your mind. You can definitely sage out your mind. Your mind is powerful. You can manifest anything that you want. Okay, by first manifesting it mentally, okay? That's you setting that intention. All right, somebody's going to be arrested. Somebody could even had a dream or a vision that they're going to be arrested, or they're receiving signs from spirit that they're going to be going to jail. It's very gray in this person's energy. It's very gray. And I feel like they have a choice to make. And one of those choices is jail time. That's being divinely guided by spirit here. Alright? I feel like... Stop! You're laughing like that.
I feel like this is gonna be the end.
Alright, you guys. Mani, I need you to get out the video, okay?
Okay.
But anyways, put my cards down.
I
feel like when these copycat envious people try to send you like dark magic, I feel like it bounces back onto your enemy. Not just onto them, but onto your enemy as well. Your local enemy spirit is saying the person you've been dealing with recently that also been trying to set you up, take you down. Your prayers
also
bounce that energy right onto your energy. You're that powerful, divine feminine
also and masculine.
Mani, please. Y'all been calling on spirit, though. Even your children been helping you spiritually, okay? Yeah. In the astral I'm hearing, y'all may even dream with your kids, all right? Like, have dreams with your kids. Somebody wants an apology here. I don't know why they want an apology from you. They may want forgiveness here, and they expect you to apologize in return. But I'm going to put that back, because that would just flip out. Let's keep going. Oh, my gosh. All these cards. All these cords. Somebody was trying to do some cord cutting too. Between you and your abundance, your destiny here. Yeah, something that's meant to be for you. This relationship is magical, it's meant to be. They were trying to cut the cord between you and your spouse, your divine feminine, okay? Your twin, your soulmate, all right, your fake ass ex was trying to cut all and any cords with who you're meant to be with. Doing spell work. That was one of the many phases that you went through, with these people lying on you, you know, and talking about you behind your back, lying on you behind your back, and then doing spell work. All right, and I'm hearing spell work in your face. It's like, their spirit is saying that because it's like, you know that they're doing spell work. It's like they're lying, saying that they're not, telling people that they're not doing it, but they're doing it, and you clearly see it from the energy that's being sent to you and that you're feeling that these people are doing it or that this person is. Y'all, when I say these people, it's because energetically, it's more than one. And that's the energy that spirit is giving me, and that's what's coming out of my mouth. Okay, but I'll try to find a better term if it's confusing for y'all. Some of you guys could be, oh my gosh, never mind. Lying came out again. Somebody's lying on you saying that you're having sexual fantasies about them. They're saying that they feel you pulling on them sexually, and that's why they're doing sex magic on you. I feel like they could even be doing magic to, like, to get you to stop, you know, having sex, so you won't even have no sexual desire. This person is lying on you heavy. They're like a sex demon. This person could be like a sex demon, like a succubus or incubus. All right, some of y'all could have came across that type of person. Manifest came out. I do feel like it was manifesting against you, but your desires are within reach. So I feel like these people try to hide your blessings. They try to shut down your throat chakra and hide your blessings. Okay? So you won't be a star. So you won't shine. And they was even doing spell work on you so you won't lie, quote unquote. But you was never lying in the first place. You always spoke your truth. Alright, that's for someone. Alright, yeah, they were just mad because you're leveling up. They were trying to shut the door, alright, on you from leveling up. Alright? They was almost like trying to say that you're the skeleton and try to close you in the closet and steal your shine, your spotlight. You are leveling up in life. Yes, we've been getting that level up energy for a long time. Okay? People around you always jump into conclusions because your energy is just too powerful. It just makes people just expect the worst. Like, you want to do something bad and horrible, and you don't. They just jump into conclusions because really they're insecure because of how powerful you are. All right, and it's not to be funny, but it's just what it is. All right, somebody, when this jump into conclusion in Christmas always giving like Christmas gifts, your blessings. It's like somebody got jealous behind your blessings, okay? Like, about your blessings. They were jealous of it. Okay, they were jealous of your blessings. What am I talking about? They were jealous of your blessings. And they jumped to conclusions and started doing spell work. It's almost like they thought to themselves, oh, you trying to steal their blessings because you're so truly blessed. And they thought that they can steal your blessings, your desires here. You're desirable by many. This person is hating because many people love you. And I'm hearing many people done spell work on you. That's true. Somebody needs to go to a therapist because a lot of their spell work backfired and it's affecting their mental space. Someone needs to visit a therapist. Some of you guys had to go to couples therapy, or you feel like you need to go to like marital therapy or something because there's a lot of blockages in your love life. What's going on? Life purpose. Some of you guys was conflicted even with your life purpose. It's like you had to go to a therapist and really talk with a therapist, even with spirit, you know, about your person and your life purpose. Like, you had to go to therapy. It's because somebody did spell work on you to make you leave, well, derail. Y'all, let me listen to what spirit's saying. I spirit say one thing and I be saying another. To make you derail, okay, from your journey, okay, for you to just get off course. It's like, whoever this is that did spell work on you, they wanted you to, you know, get off course from your spiritual journey, your life purpose, and your relationship. All right? They wanted you to do something new. They didn't want you to fulfill your life purpose. For some of you guys, this could have been a mom. All right? She could have did this. Damn, that's some hard shit to deal with right there. Find out your own mother did that. Humor, and these people was laughing at you. I feel like somebody's gonna find out that their mom could have been doing spell work on them behind their back, okay? And that's gonna be heartbreaking to them because they was just laughing at you. Maybe because you could have went through something like that where a family member could have done spell work on you, all right? And they was laughing at you, and now they're going to find out that could happen to them, that their own family member was trying to stop them from leveling up, trying to dim their light, their shine. All right? Now they want to leave everything in the past. Now that's, once that's be revealed, spirit warned them. We've been getting that warning energy, right? I don't think I uploaded that video. No, I did not. But these people was warned. Alright? These people was warned. And they did not listen. They egos. They don't want to admit that they was in their ego, but they was. They are. You know? I always talk about having a healthy ego. Alright? Because that's how you set your boundaries. That's how you stay safe and protected. That's how you stay grounded. Okay? Your ego is attached to you for a reason. You don't want to be out here damaged. You know, when people have damaged egos, they typically turn into narcissists, people pleasers. You know, they don't love themselves. They don't have boundaries set. Anyone can just come into their energy and just do whatever they want. Okay, that's why a lot of people don't like you and don't like to be your friend, is because you speak truth and you set boundaries. It's not your fault that you are protective of your energy. Okay,
and hi, guys.
Do it again.
Hi.
And it's as simple as that. Now, Mina saying hi, guys. Alright, yeah, somebody could have learned how to do spell work throughout some point of their lifetime, and they could have been doing some occult shit to on people, like, they spell work. I'm seeing occult things, and it's like they could have learned some type of occult, like witchcraft, and they've been doing witchcraft, okay? Addiction. Someone could be facing addiction. Somebody could be addicted to witchcraft. That could be the damn secret, is that somebody's addicted to witchcraft. They're always doing witchcraft. They're always doing witchery. And that's why they need therapy, because... Amani, don't be loud. That's why they need therapy, because they've done so much witchcraft, and it's backlash. It's backlash, and you're divinely guided. This person was guided towards you so you can heal them. And they chose to send you evil eye instead. And they chose to point their gun at you and try to kill you. This is, could even be someone that kills with magic. That's why your energy is protected from them. This caution. Spirit told this person, proceed with caution messing with you, because it's a death zone. It's war zone fighting with you. And this person, they took a leap of faith. And now it backfired. Spirit warned them and told them it's a war zone messing with you. They ain't take it seriously. Okay, they ain't take it seriously. So now it's karma. These are where the cards are, you guys. If y'all was curious to see. I really hope y'all can hear me well. Y'all don't come in here. No, Mino. Bino Fino. This is like really... I feel like somebody did not want this information to come out. Alright, they wanted to say this about you. That you may be addicted to spell work. And you doing spells. And you do separation spells. And that's just not like you. That you don't even look like the type to do that. That's what I'm getting. Like, that's the energy that these people are getting from you. Is that you're not like that. Okay, you're not like that. That's why the energy backfired. People could see it on this person that they do that. Like, yeah, they look like they the type to do that. They look like they're the type. Because they know these people. All right, you may not know these people. That's probably why you won't expect it. But these people know whoever this person is that is addicted to spell work. All right, that's envious. Okay, that was talking about you or being stupid. Basically, they know them. Okay, so that's why it's not surprising. It's not surprising. It's not. Look, karma. I'm hearing karmic and karmic justice here. Yeah, look. You're blocked from this person, from this person's karma that they were sending you. Alright? Yeah, look, they was doing black magic here. They was teaming up against you to do bad things. Alright? They were teaming up against you to do bad things, and that energy circled back around onto them. Their hands are dirty. Their hands is not clean. They could have washed their hands after they did their ritual, so their hands could be clean, and it came right back. Your ancestors are more powerful than them. Your ancestors came right to them. It's like if they open up a portal with their candle magic, your ancestors came through that portal and put that shit back on them. Yeah, and your ancestor did some type of binding or hexing for that spell to not work. Okay? People are crazy here. You can't trust them. Don't trust them. Don't trust them, okay? If they be coming to you, telling you stuff about what they feel and what somebody say, don't listen to it. Okay? Yeah, look, you trust your own intuition. Don't trust theirs. Trust your own intuition, Spirit is saying. You're not binded or hexed. You're not stressed. You're not worried. You're not in fear. You are trusted. You are trusted. I'm hearing entrusted. So it's like you are guided by your trusted spirit guides. And it's like they trust you. They trust you. That's why you're not binded or stuck. And that's why your ancestors are going to ride for you. This person could even be sending demons after you, after your destiny to change it. I'm sending a lot of energy after you, though. But you're divinely guided and protected. I see that. You're ordained for greatness, for wish fulfillment, for emotional fulfillment here. It's coming. Victory and success is coming. Cancer energy here. You're great. You're bliss. Virgo energy is somebody reflecting on how they lost. And how they're still not happy, how they're still not prosperous. You have blissful, graceful energy around you. You took a leap of faith and you knew exactly what you was doing. You are headed towards success and victory with this Ace of Swords, but it's like you stepped into the paint. So whatever it is that you started or whatever journey you began, you stepped in with clarity and with wisdom and with grace and with knowledge and with clarity on the fact that you want to do this. Like, this is what's yours. Okay, and people was spying on you, jealous of you, and spited you. Okay, they spite you because you took a leap of faith on your fool's journey, your soul's purpose, your life, your destiny. They didn't want you to receive your blessings. They didn't want you to be balanced. They didn't want the soul contract to be balanced. So it's like they wanted to keep you in a karmic cycle so you won't be ascended. They wanted to keep you in a karmic cycle. And now they shall pay. I always say that because it's true. These people really try to bind you, though, and keep you stuck so you won't come out of this witchcraft. And you came out anyway because you're blessed and protected by your past loved ones, your ancestors, your family, your spirituality here, your spirit, okay? Your everything around you is protecting you from these evil, spiteful people that was jealous of your blessing. Okay, you're protected. These people, they can't see you anymore. That's what I'm getting. You could be blocking them, but they receiving a tower. You're receiving a huge tower for trying to steal your Ace of Wands. What you manifested. Amani, you gotta leave her alone because she's too loud. They was evil eyeing you. They were not happy for you. They were trying to say, for some of you guys, you're not intuitive. You don't have an intuition. You're not gifted. You're not psychic. You emotionally unbalanced. Whatever it is that they suffer from, they try to put it on you. They have a lot of mental thoughts. Like, it's unclear and it's unbalanced with this King of Cups reverse. It's like they emotionally unbalanced. And it caused them to overthink and just have stressful thoughts. Like, this is someone that could be stressed emotionally. They could be going through a lot of emotional stress. Somebody could be emotionally stressed. They could have went through emotional abuse. Okay? That's why they need therapy, or is going to therapy, all right? Because they're dealing with a lot of conflict, emotional stress here. And it's like back-to-back conflict and backlash and clashing. Back-to-back-to-back. It caused them a tower. They're not happy. They're not happy, all right? And their energy is open. Whatever they open their energy to is not good. I feel like their near future is not going to be good financially. Let's just say that. And they're going to have to watch you be great. Okay? They're going to be mad about it, but oh well. I feel like, you know, for some of you guys, you may never deal with this person ever. You know, after the crap that they put you through, you may never deal with them ever again. Or other people are just not, they're not going to trust them. Amani, don't come on the bed. They're not going to trust them anymore. They're going to look at them as money hungry. I'm hearing broke. So somebody could be trying to say you money hungry and you broke here. Somebody could have been laughing at that. Things about to balance out for you. Go this way, Mina. Yeah, they could have been laughing at your finances. Things about to balance out for you. All right? Somebody's secrets are, somebody's skeletons is coming out. It's like somebody had a dream or vision that somebody was trying to steal your glow up, your level up. Okay? Yeah. And whatever they stole, all they stole was whatever unwanted energy that you don't even need. All right? Whatever they was laughing at, now you laughing at them. Spirit is saying, yeah, let them laugh, but guess what? You leveling up. They ain't laughing no more. Look, it flipped out in reverse because you still leveling up. Somebody had a dream or a vision that their magic did not work and that they leveling up. And that they could have woke up with, like, back pain after. That's one scenario as well. That could have been their sign of backfire. Okay? And, you know, whatever else I said earlier. Okay? Because I can't remember everything. But they ain't going to be laughing no more because things are balancing out for you. If they try to, like, send you to jail, put, you know, use the law against you, you're coming out of that alive, I'm hearing. Maybe because you was really worried about it emotionally. Like, you really thought something bad was going to happen to you. But no, nothing's going to happen. It worked out in your favor here. Look, because you're protected. Somebody tried to steal your destiny. They did. But they can't. Okay, you're destined for greatness. You're destined to do whatever it is that you're meant to do. So that's why they evil plans never work. All right? And even if they try to break down your stability, you are blessed enough to create new. Okay? But you're coming out of that stagnant energy. Like, this person, they try to keep you trapped. Try to keep you, like, put you in some type of prison. Somebody try to put you in prison. And you're coming out of that heavy binding energy. Somebody could have put like a binding spell for you to go to prison or like a curse for you to go to jail. And you're coming out of that. Okay, to block you from finding love. To block your path. Okay. Your old lover could have been trying to put you to jail. That's being rejected. That case could be getting thrown out. Okay. They can call the cops many times. Alright, nothing they do is going to work. They're worried. They're worried. Somebody could have called the cops a bunch of times, and now they're worried because the cops are rejecting them, or the cops are just not coming and telling them they can't come.
Mommy, can't put me here. Nina, follow me. March, march, march.
All right, so somebody is getting exposed. For doing witchcraft. Like, somebody's going to get exposed for that. For doing it on someone else. We have death and altar. Like, spirit is saying, them messing with you completely messed up their outcome. Alright? But somebody did a death ritual. And I'm hearing deathbed. Alright? They probably wanted you to be on some type of deathbed here. But somebody did a death spell at their ritual. I mean, at their altar. And we have shadow and security. Wait, I didn't mean to grab that one. We have shadow. So this is scary mirror, but anything. Anyway, everything is being mirrored. Okay, mirrored back. Everything is being mirrored back. All right, everything is being mirrored back to these karmics. They could have saw some type of shadow hovering over them. It's like these people just can't believe it. They may have never experienced this high level of like back to cinder before, or like, you know, I don't know. But I'm just getting that. Like, somebody never experienced this type of like spiritual attack. There we go. It's more of like a spiritual attack. They never experience the type of spiritual attack. Yeah, look, it was very intense. Intensification. It was very intense here. They're magic. It backfired. Alright, somebody could have did some type of fertility spell. Alright, written some out. No, put some energy out into the universe, I should say. Not written, but send some energy out into the universe for you to have bad fertility. But this air and imagination, I feel like somebody did some type of candle magic. Okay, to manifest some type of timeline for you. Okay, yeah, and to curse and hex your prosperity. We already said that. Yeah, your chalice. Your golden chalice here. Somebody was definitely trying to steal that. That energy is coming back around again. You're blessed. Your blessings is cooking up with this containment. Your blessings is cooking up here. Look, magic. Alright, candles. Wow, I did tell you that somebody was doing some spell work on your blessings and your golden chalice, your intuition. Your golden chalice is your intuition as well, your spiritual gifts. Alright, connected with your royal blood. Somebody did some spell work on that and is being exposed. They try to cloak themselves. Ha! You're protected. Boundaries. Ha ha ha. It's so funny when they be thinking they're protected. Alright, they were jealous of your growth. You will grow from this situation. You were meant to grow from this situation. Alright, you were never meant to be stagnant. A lot of things is happening behind the scenes. Behind the scenes, a lot of these people are going to see how far you've grown. How powerful you are. And I'm getting like you are proof that you ain't do anything. So it's like you know you ain't do anything to no one. So you don't have to worry. Alright, so there's a lot going on behind the scenes. Things are happening that you can't see. Yeah, blackmail. Somebody's about to get blackmailed. Because somebody did some witchcraft and it backfired and they don't like it. So now they're about to blackmail them. Someone could be getting blackmailed because they lied. They got lied to. Remember lying came out? Somebody could have lied and said that you were doing sex magic on their person. You want their person. That was a lie. That was a whole lie. And somebody's being exposed that they does black magic. You have a promotion coming with this new job. You got a new job. A lot of you guys are getting a new job. Somebody was doing spell work to stop you from getting a job. I'm getting, like, blackmail. Like, these people was using spirits and demons to almost, like, blackmail your spirit, guys. Like, it's like, if you give Divine Feminine a new job or their blessing that they manifest, then we're going to kill Divine Feminine. And your ancestors had to fight. So that's where the war came in. It's like, B-I-T-C-H, how dare you. But you guys are going to have a promotion, a level up. Okay, somebody would just be in a performer. They were just faking. They were not real. But with this entertainment industry, some of you guys are into that. You guys are trying to put yourself out there and be more in that entrepreneur, be more creative. Spirit keep telling me, like, reminding me, like, someone is being exposed for being crazy. Yeah, like, they're mentally bound to some type of spirit or entity. Okay, feeling bound to a current situation. That's their karma. They can't come out of this. I'm hearing everyone is going to know, even though it's behind the scenes now, everyone is going to know with this new view, and everyone is going to be seeing this person from a new perspective, and that's of blackmail and abuse and craziness. All right, this person is probably going to have to get a new job after all this. If this was someone at your job trying to blackmail you, they're going to have to get a new job. Okay, somebody's seeing that someone is just chaotic here. Yeah, that they're missing some damn pieces in their brain. That's what I'm getting, honestly. You're a missing piece. You're missing a major piece of a puzzle, of the puzzle. Yeah, so I feel like, honestly, not everything is being revealed right now about, like, what this person done to you. And it's, like, I'm getting more and more things are going to be revealed. Like, what's being revealed now is not even compared to all that they've done. But I'm seeing, like, this person is mainly getting exposed. Like, they're being exposed for being, like, the crazy one or some shit like that. Okay, yeah, that they jump to conclusions with you. You may be jumping to conclusions without all the information. Yeah, like, somebody to jump to conclusions. And they try to say that you did that. But that's why spirit blocked their black magic. And this is why you blocked their energy. Because they jump to conclusions. And it could even be an altercation or a fight may break out. A physical altercation may break out. Just because this person jumped to conclusions, it may even turn into like a real serious fight. Like a real serious thing. Because I'm seeing like even court. Like an argument in court. But someone has like a weird obsession. Alright? Someone is obsessed with you. I'm not even just getting obsessed with you. Like somebody just have like an obsession. Like I said, obsessed with magic. Obsessed with spell work here. Alright? I feel like this is someone that does spell work to clear away people's energy. Like to clear out their money. You know, clear away their blessings. You know, clear away their stability so they can just start at zero. But spirit wants you to relax your mind. Y'all have a lot of people that think about you. Okay, because they are obsessed with you. So you just need to, like, clear your energy. Alright? They're focused on your upgrade in the that Thanksgiving energy is giving me, you know, gratitude. And spirit is like gonna gift you for being in gratitude. Thanksgiving is giving me thanks and giving. Like, thank you for giving into the universe, Divine Feminine. Okay, being of service to the universe. Now I'm gonna give you an upgrade because you passed that test. You leveled up, like we said. You focus on your desires, not codependency, which means you was not stuck on being money. It's like, look in my situation, y'all see I still come here and you do my reads, you know, for you guys, because I desire it. I'm not allowing the codependency of money not coming in right now to stop me from doing it. That's not the case. I actually enjoy reading tarot. I do. That's why I read tarot in the midst of my kids. It's a passion for me. It doesn't drain my energy, okay? And y'all could be going through a situation like that where someone was trying to call you a fraud. There's someone that's a fraud, and they're trying to call you a fraud. And people are starting to see that. You the real deal, like, honestly. This situation is coming to a dead end. The hidden truth is being exposed. They're trying to, you know, look, black magic, listen. Oh, my God, you guys, the card was like this and at the bottom of the deck. And when I flipped over, it's black magic. Somebody's trying to hide the fact that they did black magic, but they can't because the truth is out. Either somebody knows this about this person, okay? And it's the same person I was laughing at you now. Alright? You might have not known they was laughing at you, but they was. Okay? But they're trying to deny it. But they did. Spirit warned them. They got a whisper in their ear from Spirit. From an angel. A guardian angel told them, don't do it. Mind your business. Don't do it. And they did it anyway. They suppressed that emotion. They submerged it. They did not listen. They concealed it. And they listened to what a copycat had to say. And they got, and that person was a catfish. And they got, and they got karma. These people don't want you to know this, but it's already exposed, okay? This person got is getting caught up for being a fraud, for doing something for money. And Spirit saying this all happened so they can be exposed for that. All right, because they try to say that's what you are like. And no, it's just because they're jealous of you and they're not healing, they're not balanced. They're not cleansing their space. All right, they just obsessed with witchcraft. Okay, I met a few karmics that's like obsessed with witchcraft here. It's like, it's one thing to manifest, but... You know, you trying to control people in their lives and you like to see people experience karma. That's not something that I will, you know, feed off of. I don't want to feed off of that type of emotion of, yeah, I took them down. Like, no, I want to see everybody happy, and I mean that. I know not everyone feels that way, wanting to see everyone happy, but I do. All right, and these people, money spells backfired. Their dark hexing money spells backfired on them. They're gonna have like a dent in their finances. All right, and it's not wishing it upon them. It just that's just what it is. But I love y'all. Namaste.